Hi, I'm Alicia, and today I'm going to show you how to use and optimize WordPress revisions on your website. In this video, we'll introduce you to WordPress revisions and explain where to find them. Then, we'll walk you through how to use revisions and keep them from negatively impacting your site. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in the video's description. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. All right, now let's get to it. WordPress revisions automatically record any changes you make to pages or posts on your website. A new copy of a page is created every 60 seconds by default, as well as every time you click on the Save Draft, Publish, or Update buttons. WordPress revisions are helpful for any site owner. They serve as backups you can restore in the event of an unexpected disruption, such as closing your browser tab accidentally or having a power outage. They also enable you to revert to older versions of your content. For example, you might learn that a post isn't performing as well as it used to, and you want to roll back some recent changes. Revisions are also super helpful when you have a team working on your website's content. In addition to letting you view what post or page edits were made, the WordPress revisions feature also records the username and timestamp of those changes. This can increase transparency and make collaborating on editorial work easier. WordPress revisions can present a serious problem if you don't manage them properly. Essentially, the more pages and posts you add to your website, the more revisions it'll generate. If you have a large website or make changes frequently, this can quickly lead to unnecessary database bloat. That's because every time a revision is created, an additional row is added in the WordPress database's WP Post table with a post type value of revision. The larger your database is, the more storage space it'll occupy. Unfortunately, this can slow your site down and lead to longer loading times, hampering your site's user experience and search engine optimization. Therefore, it's critical to learn how to control revisions in WordPress to your advantage. Whether you want to delete revisions entirely, disable or limit them, or optimize your revisions database, you have many options at your disposal. Before discussing the different ways you can use and change the revisions settings in WordPress, it's important to first understand where to find them. On the editor screen of your post or page, go to the right-hand menu and click on the Document tab. If revisions are enabled and changes have been made, you'll see the number of revisions under the Status and Visibility section. Click on this to visit the revisions page, where you can view all the saved edits and compare any two revisions side by side. You'll see two columns. The left side displays previous version of your post or page, and the right shows you the version you've selected. You can use the revision slider to browse through the various restore points. This system highlights the content that was added or removed. If you want to keep the existing version and return to the editor screen without making any changes, you can do so by simply clicking on either the article title or the Return to Editor link at the top of the screen. Sometimes you may want to undo changes made in WordPress. When this happens, WordPress revisions make doing so quick and easy. By default, WordPress displays the revisions for a post or page sequentially. However, if you want to view or compare non-sequential changes, you can do so by selecting the Compare Any Two Revisions option at the top of the screen. Then, select the version you want to compare it to. Whenever you're done viewing and comparing revisions, you can restore an older version by clicking on Restore This Version. Note that if you click this button, it will automatically restore the version you're comparing against, the one shown in the revision screen's right side column. Typically, WordPress revisions are enabled by default. However, depending on your hosting provider or the process used to install WordPress, this feature may be disabled. It's also possible that you or someone else on your team disabled it at some point. Whatever the case, if you want to enable revisions in WordPress, you can do so manually by editing the wp-config.php file in your site's root directory. You can do this via a SFTP client. If you're not a Kinsta user and your host uses cPanel, you can use its file manager tool instead. Once you locate and open the file, search for the following line of code. Change the false value to true. If there's no line like this where it says the following, add the following line of code. don't forget to save the file. Now, when you log back into WordPress, you should see the revisions feature enabled. To ensure that it's up and running, open the editor for any page or post and check for the revisions option under the document tab. Conversely, you may want to disable revisions in WordPress altogether. Keep in mind that you can also keep this feature enabled and limit or delete revisions to minimize the amount of space they take up in your database. We'll discuss how to do it in the next section. However, if you find no purpose or use for this feature, you can turn it off completely. To do so, use the same method we discussed before, editing your site's wp-config.php file. The only difference is that the value should be set to false rather than true. If you're not comfortable editing your wp-config.php file, you can also disable revisions in WordPress using a lightweight plugin such as Disable Post Revision. After you install and activate this tool, you can access it by going to Settings and then writing in your WordPress dashboard. Select the post types that you want to disable revisions for and then save your changes. That's it. The longer you run your site, the more revisions you're likely to have stored in your database. If you've spent years updating and editing your content, you're naturally going to accumulate many revisions. For example, if you have an older site, it's not uncommon to have over 100 revisions on the oldest or frequently updated pages. Let's say that you have 800 pages and posts on your site. If each of those has 100 revisions, this amounts to more than 80,000 entries in your database. It's a common issue in WooCommerce stores too. Such a buildup can happen quickly and occurs behind the scenes. Luckily, aside from disabling revisions completely, there are a few methods you can use to optimize your WordPress revisions. These include deleting WordPress revisions and limiting WordPress revisions. You can use these two methods to remove revisions from your site, manually or via a plugin. We recommend using a plugin because it's quicker and doesn't require you to modify your site's files. However, if you're a developer and want a more advanced method, you can also delete revisions manually. If you want to delete your revisions in WordPress using a plugin, there are a few options to choose from. For Kinsta users, it's worth noting that some popular performance optimization plugins are on our banned list of plugins. They're barred from our platform because they tend to cause problems with our server-level performance optimizations and security features. We recommend using WP Sweep. WP Sweep is a free, easy-to-use tool that will make cleaning up old revisions in your database quick and simple. To install it, navigate to Plugins, then Add New in your WordPress dashboard. Search for the plugin, then select Install Now and Activate. Next, navigate to Tools and then Sweep. On this screen, you'll see a list of revisions and the total amount that exists. If you click on Details, you can access a list of posts that will be affected. Once you've reviewed the information and are sure that nothing important will be deleted, click on the Sweep button. Repeat this process for every item on your list. As you sweep through your revisions, a dialog box will display the number of revisions being processed. Note that for performance reasons, this plugin only displays 500 items at a time. If you have an older site, you can expect many more revisions to be listed than in our example, as we're using a test site for this demonstration. You can also manually delete WordPress revisions. There are two ways to do it, with the help of a plugin or deleting entire entries directly from the database. We recommend using the second method only if you're a developer and want to avoid installing another plugin. For the first method, download and activate the free Simple Revisions Delete plugin. It doesn't have an admin or settings page. To use it, visit the page or post editor, and you'll find a delete link beside each revision. Now you can verify and manually delete revisions you don't need. It's a good solution to micromanage your revisions. If you prefer the second, more advanced approach, then you can proceed by accessing PHP MyAdmin and running an SQL query. It's important to be careful with this method. There are many bad snippets of code floating around the WordPress repository forums. Some of them may end up deleting something important on your site. Or worse, they can bring your site down altogether. To safely delete post revisions in your WordPress via a query, log into your PHP MyAdmin account, select your WordPress database from the left-hand panel, and click on the SQL tab. You can then enter a command to run on your WordPress database. In the command box, enter the following. You'll need to replace WP underscore with whatever you use as your WordPress database prefix. Then click on Go to run the command. Any revisions you had in your database will now be deleted. Another option you might like, if you're a WordPress developer, is to delete your post revisions with WPCLI. Here's an example of a WPCLI command you could use. Keep in mind that deleting old revisions from your database won't stop WordPress from creating them for future pages and posts. Therefore, it's a smart idea to limit the number of saved revisions so they don't get out of control moving forward. By limiting the number of WordPress revisions you allow, you can minimize how often you'll have to clean up your database. As with deleting WordPress revisions, you can either do this manually or by using a plugin. If you prefer to use a plugin to limit WordPress revisions, you can use the free WP Revisions Control plugin. This plugin enables you to limit the number of WordPress revisions or disable them altogether. Once it's installed and activated on your site, you can limit post revisions by navigating to Settings, then Writing in your admin dashboard, and then clicking on the tab. Next, set a number of revisions for each post type. If you have any custom post type, you can also see it listed under here. There's no limit to how many revisions you can set. On the other hand, setting it to 0 will disable revisions for that post type altogether. When you're done, click on the Save Changes button at the bottom of the screen, and you're ready to go. To manually set a limit on the revisions you allow in WordPress, you can edit the code in your wp-config.php file. As we mentioned earlier, depending on your host, you can do this via cPanel and File Manager or an SFTP client. After opening your wp-config.php file, add the following line of code. We've used 3 as an example value above, but you can change this number to reflect however many revisions you want your database to store per page or post. Please save the file when you're done and re-upload it to the server. Remember, a WordPress site's performance depends on its database. Start optimizing it today. Do you have any questions about using and optimizing WordPress revisions? Let us know in the comment section below. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. Let us show you the Kinsta difference. Try a free demo of our My Kinsta dashboard at demo.kinsta.com. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.